to the podium, please welcome the Ambassador Al-Buyadi. Now, Al-Buyadi is a former ambassador of Iraq to the United Nations. He was the chair of the Disarmament Commission and got Iraq elected to the Commission on the Status of Women. And meeting that's going on right now for the next 2 weeks at the UN. And he is currently a professor of political science at Rutgers University, right over the bridge in New Jersey. Please welcome to the stage, Ambassador Al-Buyadi.
Hello, everyone. I think you can easily tell that we should all be happy today, because even our Mother Earth become happy when the weather forecast says it's going to be snowing today, while we enjoy a very good weather. Ambassador Angelo Tagliano, Special Envoy of the President of Sao Tome and Principe, Excellencies, colleagues, friends, ladies and gentlemen. It is my honor and pleasure to address this gathering of ambassadors, diplomats, and intellectuals on this day of International Day of Happiness. It is a very well-known fact that Bhutan was the first country in the world who brought the attention of the importance of happiness as an indication for progress and prosperity. So I commend Bhutan for that important and unique initiative. Back in 2012, when I was ambassador of Iraq to the United Nations, I went to the Secretary General with a team of happiness advocates. And then I went to President of the General Assembly, Nasser Abdelaziz Nasser at that time. And I suggested that we should adopt a resolution to proclaim an International Day of Happiness, just like the International Day of Peace and so on. I have their strong support. I submitted a resolution to the President of the General Assembly, and he presented as the President resolution, and then it was adopted by consensus. And you know, at the UN, it's so difficult to have consensus on a very small sentence, let alone a complete resolution. For a simple reason, if a Western country present a resolution, Eastern country will oppose it, regardless. If a developed country present a resolution, the developing country will reject it. And so on and so forth. I chaired the third committee. I chaired the sixth committee. I chaired the UN Disarmament Commission. The most difficult issue and task was to have consensus sometimes about one word. And just an example, the whole world now is suffering from terrorism, but the UN has been discussing terrorism and they couldn't agree on a definition for decades, not years. So that resolution, which was adopted by consensus, meant 193 countries agree that they should celebrate the International Day of Happiness every year. I'm glad to see that since 2012, there are so many organizations, non-profit and profit organizations, who are advocating happiness, and people are becoming more aware about the importance of happiness, not only for well-being, but even for other issues. Why we should be happy? Very simple question, very important. Although my colleague, the ambassador of Hungary, said if you want to be happy for one day, or 1 hour, or 1 month, or the whole life, of course, if you help other people, you should be the happier person on earth. But every one of us, when we wake up in the morning and we are healthy, we are much better than millions of people with serious illnesses. And if we wake up and we have a roof on top of our heads, we are much better than millions of people who are homeless. If we have a job, and believe me, so many people, including in the United States, the richest country in the world, are jobless, are unemployed, then we should be happy. And so on, so forth. So there are so many things which make us feel happy. I saw a video of a young boy in my country, very poor, who was taking people from one side of a river to other in a small boat to make a living. And he saw two tourists, elderly European tourists or Westerners, who stuck in the mud near the river. They walked to the river and they stuck in the mud. Half the body was in the mud. He tried to help them getting them out, he couldn't. The man had a camera, expensive camera with a tripod or a stand. He took the camera away. The lady had a handbag. He took the handbag away. He could run away with the bag with the money. He tried to pull them. He couldn't. He lay down on the mud and the clay to make his body as a boat so they could climb on his body to get out. And he walked away without asking a reward